إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. This is the class of tafsir from Surah Al-Baqarah, inshallah from verse 137. Verse 137 of Surah Al-Baqarah. We first read from the tafsir of Sheikh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah. قال رحمه الله تعالى في قول الله عز وجل: فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما هم في شقاق فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم. أي فإن آمن أهل الكتاب بمثل ما آمنتم به، يا معشر المؤمنين من جميع الرسل وجميع الكتب، الذين أول من دخل فيهم وأولى خاتمهم وأفضلهم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والقرآن، وأسلموا لله وحده ولم يفرقوا بين أحد من رسل الله، فقد اهتدوا للصراط المستقيم الموصل لجنات النعيم. أي فلا سبيل لهم إلى الهداية إلا بهذا الإيمان، لا كما زعموا بقولهم كونوا هودا أو نصارى تهتدوا، فزعموا أن الهداية خاصة بما كانوا عليه، والهدى هو العلم بالحق والعمل به، وضده الضلال عن العلم والضلال عن العمل بعد العلم، وهو الشقاق الذي كانوا عليه لما تولوا وأعرضوا، فالمشاق هو الذي يكون في شق، والله ورسوله في شق، ويلزم من المشاقة المحادة والعداوة البليغة التي من لوازمها بذل ما يقدرون عليه من أذية الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. فلهذا وعد الله رسوله أن يكفيه إياهم، لأنه سميع لجميع الأصوات باختلاف اللغات على تفنن الحاجات، العليم بما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم بالغيب والشهادة بالظواهر والبواطن، فإذا كانوا كذلك كفاك الله شرهم. وقد أنجز الله لرسوله وعده وسلطه عليهم حتى قتل بعضهم وسبى بعضهم وأجلى بعضهم وشردهم كل مشر، ففيه معجزة من معجزات القرآن، وهو الإخبار بالشيء قبل وقوعه فوقع طبق ما أخبر. In this ayah, in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 137, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ. فَإِنْ آمَنُوا, so if they believe, means the people of the book, if they do believe, بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ, the like of that which you, O believers, believe. If they do believe, what you believe, فَقَدْ اهْتَدَوْا, then they are rightly guided. They are rightly guided. وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاقٍ. But if they turn away, then they are only in opposition. فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهِ, so Allah will suffice for you against them. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ, and he, Allah Azza wa Jal, is the all-hearer, the all-knower. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he mentioned in the previous ayah what a believer should say and should believe, which is to believe in Allah Azza wa Jal and all that of his books he sent down, to believe the messengers like Prophet Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Asbat, and Prophet Musa, Isa, and all the prophets of Allah, to believe all of them, and not to make any decision between them by believing some and disbelieving others. Rather, believe in all of them and believe in all their books, especially the seal of the messengers, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the biggest books from the books of Allah, the Quran. And that وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ, that we also submit ourselves to Allah's obedience, means we follow that which we believe. Then Allah said, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ. So if they believe, means the disbelievers, the people of the book, in the like of that which you believe, O believers, the like of what you believe, مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ, that which you believe. Who are those who were believers at that time when Allah sent down this verse to His Prophet ﷺ? Who were the believers who the other people are being called to believe the like of their belief? Who were they? Now, Prophet Muhammad ﷺ and his companion. So, if the people of their time and the people of any time believe the like of what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu and his companion used to believe, what is the ruling? What they ruling with Allah Azza wa Jal? He subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَقَدْ اِهْتَدُوا. Indeed, they are rightly guided. They are upon guidance. They are upon guidance in terms of the sound knowledge and in terms of the sound action. They are truly upon guidance. This is one of the many proofs in the Quran and Sunnah which indicate the importance and the obligatory of following and taking the understanding of the Salaf Salih Ridwanullahi Ta'ala Alayhim, the Sahaba. One ayah that whoever believed the like of their belief, then he is upon guidance. As for the one who doesn't believe the like of their belief, فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاقٍ, but they are, if they turn away, then they are only in opposition. They are opposite to the truth. They are in shiqaq. Some of the scholars said, this verse is a shahid, it's a witness. It strengthened the hadith, which some of the scholars authenticated. And some of them disauthenticated in terms of the chain. That is, when Prophet ﷺ was asked the group who will be safe from the 73, he ﷺ said, "Man kana ala mithli ma ana alayhi al-yawm wa ashabi." Whoever is upon that which I and my companion are upon today. Some scholars, they say this wording in terms of the chain is not sound. And some of them, they say it's sound. It's sound. And also, so the ulama, they mentioned that this verse, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا. This verse is a witness for the meaning of that hadith. Now, if they believe the like of what you believe, then they are guided. And also, the ulama, they mentioned that this ayah, amantum, you believe, the plural of you, which in English sometimes it means one person, you. In Arabic it means more than one. You, if you say you, I may talk to one of you or talk to a group of you. Unlike the Arabic pronoun here, amantum, is a plural. That plural is Allah mentioned in another surah in detail, in Surah An-Nisa. Allah said, Azza wa Jal, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى. So whoever differ the prophet, the messenger after the guidance become clear to him and follow a way other than the way of the believers. Follow a way other than the way of the believers. نوليه ما تولى ونصله جهنم وساءت مصيرا. So all these verses show us the importance of believing the deen of Allah in the same way Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companion did believe. And that when it comes to the your aqidah and your religion, that you should make sure that your way of worship, your way of ibadah, aqidah, and everything about the deen to be upon the same way that the companion of the Prophet ﷺ used to be upon. And also in the same surah, Surah Al-Baqarah, the verse, the beginning, Allah said, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَاءِ أَلَا إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ السُّفَهَاءِ وَلَكِنْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. That is Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 13. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ. And when it is said to them, means the munafiqun, the hypocrites, when it is said to them, آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ, believe as the people believe, have belief. Who are those people who have belief at that time? The Prophet ﷺ and his companion. So if the munafiqeen, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned that if the hypocrites are said to believe as the people believe, what they say? قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَاء. The munafiqun say, نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْهُمْ, shall we believe as the fools have belief? عياذا بالله. Allah said, أَلَا إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ السُّفَهَاءُ وَلَكِنْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. Verily they are the fools, but they know not. So they are the fools, they are those who do not have enough intellect and do not have a wisdom. And they are those who are not upon haq, but they don't know that. The munafiqun don't know that. So whoever thinks that there is a straight way, straight path, other than the path that Prophet ﷺ and his companion used to be upon, then indeed he is safi, he is foolish, even though he may not know it. So anyone who is upon a path other than the path of the companion, he should have this understanding. You may not know it, but you are safi, no doubt. Now, if you know it, then this is disobeying Allah, عياذ بالله, intentionally and knowingly. And if you do not know it, and the person is disobeying Allah out of ignorance, he thinks that a way other than the way of the companion is sound, can be followed, then the eye is very clear. وَلَكِنَّهُمْ وَلَكِنْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But they know not. They do not know. So, again, this is from the many ayat in the Book of Allah which obligate to follow the path of the companion of the Prophet ﷺ and to understand the religion the way they understood. Allah said in the ayah, فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهِ. If they believe not in the like of that which you believe, then they are rightly... If they believe in the light of that which you believe, then they are rightly guided. But if they turn away, then they are only in opposition. فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهِ. So Allah will suffice for you against them. Now is the Messenger ﷺ. This dhamir is kaful khitab. It's not a plural. فَسَيَكْفِيكَ. Allah Azza wa Jal will suffice for you against them. Means all the mercy of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised subhanahu Azza wa Jal for his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he will subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for the messenger against his enemy. So they will not harm him. Some scholars mention when Allah sent down that verse, Prophet ﷺ said he doesn't need anyone of the companion to take care of him and to watch him and to be at security and the like. Allah promised me, فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And Allah Azza wa Jal is the all-hearer, the all-knower. All-hearer, the all-knower. So any action that the enemy of Allah are trying to use to harm the Prophet ﷺ, or any statement they go into harm with the Prophet ﷺ, Allah is aware of it. As-Sami' al-Alim, all-hearer, all-speech, all-voices. Al-Alim, all-actions. So, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal knows about all their actions, about all their statements, all their actions, including the actions of the heart, what they intending, how, and Allah promised that He will protect the Prophet Muhammad from them, how can they harm Him? Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal suffice for His messenger Muhammad alayhi salam against His enemy. Therefore, Shaykh Abdul Rahman Sa'di, he said, فَفِيهِ مُعْجِزَةٌ مِنْ مُعْجِزَاتِ الْقُرْآنِ وَهُوَ الْإِخْبَارُ بِالشَّيْءِ قَبْلَ وُقُوعِهِ فَوَقَعَ طِبْقَ مَا أَخْبَرَ. In this verse, it is one of the miracles of the miracles of the Quran. The miracles, the many proofs which shows Quran is a speech of Allah. And it is truth, it is haq. Is that? From that is the, that Allah mentioned, such will take place, and it take place. The way Allah mentioned. From that is that Allah promised the Prophet ﷺ that he will suffice for him against his enemy. That he will give, he will suffice him from their enemy, from their harm. And that's why they couldn't reach him. They couldn't reach him. They try all their best, the munafiqun, the Jewish, the idol worshippers, mushrikun. Read the history of the history, you surprise. Yani all those groups. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the controller of Mars. Allahu Akbar. If all people get together to harm you, they can't harm you except that Allah decree for you. All of them. If all of them get together to benefit you, Naam, they cannot benefit you with anything except what Allah decree for you. Which means put your trust on Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Whatever you say, whatever you're doing, don't consider the creation of Allah, rather consider Allah subhanahu. Does Allah likes? It pleases Allah. Allah wants you to do that, do it. Allah dislike that, avoid it. Naam. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was protected by Allah Azza wa Jal. Just like Allah protected Prophet Musa from Fir'aun. It's known the history of Fir'aun. Allah mentioned Surah Al-Qasas and many other surahs. How Fir'aun was planning torturing the children of Israel. And all that is to make sure that one of the children of Israel doesn't be a cause to destruction of his kingdom. And he the one who raised Prophet Musa alayhi salam in his house. Yani Fir'aun is one who raised Prophet Musa in his house. Subhanallah. And when he was young, even paying his money to Prophet Musa's mother to breastfeed him. Allahu Akbar. So until Prophet Musa, he became strong. And the people, they used to be scared, considering him from the family of the king. Naam. And so, yani, and at the end is no. Fir'aun was destroyed while he was trying to attack and to kill Prophet Musa alayhi salatu salam. and the believers. So what Allah wants, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is what's going to take place. And that doesn't mean not to take the means. We should take the means, the permissible means, to get what we like, what we see is benefit, and to avoid what's harmful. But with that action, na'am, to have that sound aqidah. Whatsoever, if you take all means, Allah doesn't make those means function, it will not. Even if your enemy throw you to a fire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want you to be burned in the fire, it will not burn you. Even the poison they gave you to poison, you will not die because of it, if Allah doesn't want that. Na'am. So the Muslim to take the means the permissible means that Allah legislate to take it, to get the good and to avoid the evil. But at the same time, he depend on Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And he put his trust on Allah. He rely on Allah always. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes happen is going to happen. What Allah doesn't make it happen, it will never ever happen. Na'am. Na'am, barakallahu fiqh. In Surah Al-Ma'id, Allah said, Wallahu ya'asimuka min al-nas. This is which verse number? Na'am. 67. Wallahu a'lam, it is that verse which the Salaf Salih mentioned that when Allah sent down that verse is when Prophet Sallam after that that no one of the companion was around him to make sure to defend him from his enemy. Wallahu ya'asimuka min al-nas. Allah is protecting you from the people. With the message of Allah. Wallahu ya'asimuka min al-nas. Na'am. What number? 67. 67. 67 of Surah Al-Ma'idah. Yes, ya ayyuha al-rasul, na'am, barakallahu fi. Ya ayyuha al-rasul, balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik. O Messenger of Allah, proclaim the message which has been sent down to you from your Lord. وَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَ. And if you do not, then you have not conveyed his message. وَاللَّهُ يَعَصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. This is the point. وَاللَّهُ يَعَصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Allah will protect you from mankind. Allah will protect you from mankind. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Verily Allah guides not the people who disbelieve. So Sheikh Sa'd is saying, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised for his messenger Muhammad. Even though it's known how his companions were few number, how his enemy were so much. So much. But with that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Wallahu ya'asimuka min al-nas. And that is the way it happened. Prophet Muhammad sallam, ماذا? At the end of his life is known, he recaptured Makkah, Khaybar, Ta'if, all that area. Rather, he sent his arm to go to the Roman arm. Na'am. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, spreading the Tawheed and the Haqq and the truth. And after a few years, after his death, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Muslim government was the strongest government on earth. After a few years. And they also, the companion of Prophet sallam, had that promise from Allah too, that they will be leaders. They will be khulafa. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Surah An-Nur. This promise for the companion that they will be leaders. They will be khulafa. And whoever fulfill those conditions, al-Iman wal-amal salih, sound aqidah and righteous action. Naam. فَسَيَكْفِيَكَوْمُ اللَّهُ وَسَمِعُ الْعَلِيمُ. So this is a proof that the Quran is from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala Azza wa Jal. Well, that's what Sheikh Sa'di Rahimahullah Ta'ala said. Sibghata Allahi wa man ahsanu min Allahi sibgha. Verse 138. Sibghata Allah. Ay ilzamu. Sibghata Allah. Ay deen Allah. صبغة الله، ومن أحسن من الله صبغة ونحن له عابدون. صبغة الله، the religion of Allah, follow the religion of Allah. ومن أحسن من الله، ومن أحسن من الله صبغة. And which صبغة, which religion can be better than Allah is? Nothing. ونحن له عابدون. And we are his worshippers. Actually, له عابدون تقديم الجار يفيد الحصر. ونحن and we believers له to Allah alone عابدون. We worship Allah alone. ونحن the ayah is له عابدون. Not عابدون له. عابدون له is we worship in him. له عابدون, to him alone we worship. That we make ikhlas. قال الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله في قوله عز وجل صبغة الله ومن أحسن من الله صبغه ونحن له عابدون، أي إلزموا صبغة الله وهو دينه وقوموا به قياما تاما بجميع أعماله الظاهرة والباطنة وجميع عقائده في جميع الأوقات حتى يكون لكم صبغة وصفة من صفاتكم، فإذا كان صفة من صفاتكم أوجب ذلك لكم الانقياد لأوامره طوعا واختيارا ومحبة، وصار الدين طبيعة لكم بمنزلة الصبغ التام للثوب الذي صار له صفة، فحصلت لكم السعادة الدنيوية والأخروية لحث الدين على مكارم الأخلاق ومحاسن الأعمال ومعالي الأمور. فلهذا قال على سبيل التعجيب المتقرر للعقول الزكية ومن أحسن من الله صبغة، أي لا أحسن صبغة من الله، أي لا أحسن صبغة من صبغته. وإذا أردت أن تعرف نموذجا يبين لك الفرق بين صبغة الله وبين غيرها من الصبغ، فقس الشيء بضده، فكيف ترى في عبد آمن بربه إيمانا صحيحا أثر معه خضوع القلب وانقياد الجوارح، فلم يزل يتحلى بكل وصف حسن وفعل جميل وخلق كامل ونعت جليل، ويتخلى من كل وصف قبيح ورذيلة وعيب، فوصفه الصدق في قوله وفعله، والصبر والحلم والعفة والشجاعة والإحسان القولي والفعلي، ومحبة الله وخشيته وخوفه ورجاؤه، فحاله الإخلاص للمعبود والإحسان للعبيد. فقس بعبد كفر بربه وشرد عنه وأقبل على غيره من المخلوقين فاتصف بالصفات القبيحة من الكفر والشرك والكذب والخيانة والمكر والخداع وعدم العفة والإساءة إلى الخلق في أقواله وأفعاله، فلا إخلاص للمعبود ولا إحسان إلى عبيده، فإنه يظهر لك الفرق العظيم بينهما، ويتبين لك أنه لا أحسن صبغة من صبغة الله، وفي ضمنه أنه لا أقبح صبغة من اتصف بغير دينه. وفي قوله ونحن له عابدون بيان لهذه الصبغة، وهي القيام بهذين الأصلين الإخلاص والمتابعة، لأن العبادة اسم جامع لكل ما يحبه الله ويرضاه من الأعمال والأقوال الظاهرة والباطنة، ولا تكون كذلك حتى يشرعها الله على لسان رسوله. والإخلاص أن يقصد العبد وجه الله وحده في تلك الأعمال، فتقديم المعمول يؤذن بالحصر. وقال ونحن لو عابدون فوصفهم باسم الفاعل الدال على الثبوت والاستقرار ليدل على اتصاف بذلك، وكونه صار صبغة له ملازما. الشيخ سعد رحمه الله when he making comment and tafsir on وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ صِبْغَةً and who is more better than Allah in religion, he mentioned, you know that by comparing the one who followed the religion of Allah in terms of عقيده, يعني in terms of manners, in terms of dealings, acts of worship, and the one who does the opposite, then there you know that no one is better than Allah in religion. That Allah's religion is the best, because Allah's religion enjoys all that which is good, all the righteous statements, all the correct actions, all the sound aqidah, and it won against the opposite. So no one is more better religion than Allah Azza wa Jal. قال تعالى قل أتحاجوننا في الله وهو ربنا وربكم ولنا أعمالنا ولكم أعمالكم ونحن له مخلصون. قل أتحاجوننا في الله وهو ربنا وربكم ولنا أعمالنا ولكم أعمالكم ونحن له مخلصون. قال الإمام الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله في هذه الآية المحاجة هي المجادلة بين اثنين فأكثر تتعلق في المسائل الخلافية حتى يكون كل من الخصمين يريد نصرة قوله وإبطال قول خصمه، فكل واحد منهما يجتهد في إقامة الحجة على ذلك، والمطلوب منها أن تكون بالتي هي أحسن بأقرب طريق يرد الضال إلى الحق ويقيم الحجة على المعاند ويوضح الحق ويبين الباطل، فإن خرجت عن هذه الأمور كانت ممارة ومخاصمة لا خير فيها وأحدثت من الشر ما أحدثت. فكان أهل الكتاب يزعمون أنهم أولى بالله من المسلمين، وهل مجرد دعوة تفتقر إلى برهان والدليل؟ فإذا كان رب الجميع واحدا ليس ربا لكم دوننا، وكل منا ومنكم له عمله، فاستوينا نحن وإياكم بذلك، فهذا لا يوجب أن يكون أحد الفريقين أولى بالله من غيره، لأن التفريق مع الاشتراك في شيء من غير فرق مؤثر دعوة باطلة، وتفريق بين متماثلين ومكابرة ظاهرة. وإنما يحصل التفضيل بإخلاص الأعمال الصالحة لله وحده، وهذه الحالة وصف المؤمنين وحدهم، فتعين أنهم أولى بالله من غيرهم لأن الإخلاص هو الطريق إلى الخلاص. فهذا هو الفرق بين أولياء الرحمن وأولياء الشيطان بالأوصاف الحقيقية التي يسلمها أهل العقول ولا ينازع فيها إلا كل مكابر جهول. ففي هذه الآية إرشاد لطيف لطريق المحاجة، وأن الأمور مبنية على الجمع بين المتماثلين والفرق بين المختلفين. قال الله تعالى، الله سبحانه وتعالى said in this verse 139, قل أتحاجوننا في الله. Say, O the Messenger of Allah Muhammad, means to the Jewish and Christian, أتحاجوننا في الله. Dispute you with us about Allah? Do you dispute with us about Allah? وهو ربنا وربكم. While he is our Lord and your Lord. ولنا أعمالنا ولكم أعمالكم. And we are to be rewarded for our deeds and you for your deeds. ونحن له مخلصون. And we are sincere to him. سبحانه وتعالى in worship and in obedience. And we worship him alone and none else. And we obey his orders. This ayah, Allah Azza wa Jal said to the Prophet Sallam to say, قل, to say to the kuffar, أتحاجوننا في الله, do you dispute with us about Allah? يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your Lord and it's also our Lord. No difference between us and you in this. We all are the servant of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah is our Lord and Allah is your Lord. This is not the issue. وَلَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. And yours is your actions and ours is our actions. So the actions is what you do, what you earn is yours. What we earn is ours. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ. This is the difference. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ. We are sincere to him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. مخلصون. Worship him alone. Obey him. This is the difference. Other than that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal, as he is your Lord, he is also our Lord. Naam. And you have your actions and we have our actions. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ And we are مُخْلِصُونَ لَهُ We worship Him alone. This is the difference. Worship Allah alone and avoid the idol worshiping. So it's not just a claim. It's rather it is actions. It is actions. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ And we are sincere to Him in worship and obedience. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ Another ayah. قال تعالى قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَقُولُوا اشْهَدُوا بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ Do you see these two ayahs are close to in meaning? Which surah is that? Surah Al Imran. Which verse? Barakallahu feek. Surah Al Imran. قُلْ أَتُحَاجُّونَنَا فِي اللَّهِ وَهُوَ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ Quran, the book of Allah, يُفَسِّرُ بَعْضُ بَعْضًا Surah Al Imran 64 Jazakallahu khair Surah Al Imran verse 64 قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ Say, O the Messenger of Muhammad يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ O people of the book People of the scripture Jewish and Christians تَعَالَوْا إِلَى كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ Come to a word That is just between us and you. A word which is fair between us and you. Naam is just between us and you. Allah like is the just. Allah na'buda illallah. What is that word? Allah na'buda illallah. That we worship none but Allah alone. O Jewish and Christian, we are calling you to something we are equal. Naam, it is to worship our Lord alone. وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا And that we associate no partner with him. It's emphasizing. أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And لَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا The same meaning. Not only that. وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ And that none of us shall take others as lords beside Allah. The same meaning. اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله. And that none of us shall take others as lords beside Allah. Now if you go to some of the streets here, you say Jesus is a Lord, that's what Naam is being negated, refuted. They say there Jesus is a Lord, Jesus is a Lord. So this is the aqidah of a Muslim to call to the people of the book, Let we come together on a word which is justice, which is haq, which is between us. No special favor for us. It's between us, which is to worship our Lord, who is our Lord, all of us. Worship him alone and not to take other gods with him. Not to worship anyone with him. Not to have any lords beside him. Why you have a problem with that? Why do you, Christian and Jewish, And idol worshippers, why do you have a problem with this word which is haq and truth? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your Lord. Naam, He's the one who created you, created everything for you. The earth, the sky, that which is between it, the stars, the sun, the moon, everything. We all benefit from the blessings and the favors of Allah. He subhanahu wa ta'ala alone is our Lord. Let we worship Him alone. If you refuse now, you say, no, you worship in Jesus, you worship in Israel, you worship in this. فَقُولُوا شَهَدُوا بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ Then bear witness that we are madam. If they turn away, say, bear witness that we are Muslims. What does mean Muslims now? What Muslim is now? Who knows what Muslim is? What Muslim is? If we have to understand the Quran. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ Say, O the people of the book, تَعَالَوْا إِلَى كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَا وَبَيْنَهُ Come to a word which is between us, which is just between us. is fair for us and for you. Allah na'budu illa Allah, not to worship anyone but Allah. Na'am. Wala nushrika bihi shay'an, not to associate anyone with him in worship. Wala yattakhidha ba'duna ba'dan arbaba min dunillah, not to take beside him lords among us. Fa in tawallu, if they turn away, faqulu, then say, ishhadu, bear witness, ماذا؟ إننا مسلمون. That we are Muslims. What Muslims here mean? موحدون. That we are worshiping who? Allah alone. We're doing two things. Islam here, two things. Doing worship and doing for who? For Allah alone. That's what Islam is. So, who then after that, if they turn away and they call other than Allah, isn't it very clear to them and to everyone who has sound intellect that they run? Naam. Subhanallah. Mahajjah. In this ayah, قُلْ أَتُحَاجُّونَنَا فِي اللَّهِ وَهُوَ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ وَلَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ. The two ayah, subhanallah. One is short, a lot of emphasizing. One is, يعني, is long, one is short, comparing to the other. But the meaning is almost the same. So this is a proof that the Muslim who is truthful in this belief that he is worshiping Allah alone, that he is upon haq, and that whoever differ him is upon falsehood. Yani, how it can be? Some people, they say, how to know if Islam is the right religion? Subhanallah. How you ask this question? Islam call people to worship the Creator alone. The rest will call people to worship the creation, regardless what that creation may be, human being, image, picture, cow, stars, statue, dead body, saints, jinn. It doesn't matter. They have the same description of being a creation. وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ عِبَادٌ أَمْثَالُكُمْ. Whoever you call in beside Allah is what? Servant like you. Yes. Means, as you are in need of Allah, they are in need of Allah too. Whatsoever you need, they are also in need of, because they are slaves like you. That's in terms of need, not in terms of honor or status, that people differ because of their actions, but in terms of being a slave of Allah. Na'am, na'am, being then here that everyone, Allah said about Prophet Isa and his mother, كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطعام. They used to eat what? The food. They used to eat the food. This to prove that they are not gods, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone who need food like you. He need food like you. He get hungry like you. He doesn't eat the food of Allah. He didn't create this food. Prophet Isa, the food he used to eat used to be always there before him. Do you think earth was created after Prophet Isa came? La. No Christian can claim that unless there are those who وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ, those who believe أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ with the belief. Al-Muhim. After that verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this verse, verse 140, أَمْ تَقُولُونَ إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ وَالْأَسْبَاطَ كَانُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا قُلْ أَأَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَتَمَ شَهَادَةً عِنْدَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَلَا تُسَأَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Or say you that Ibrahim, or you are you saying, means the Jewish and Christian, that Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq and Yaqub and Asbat, Asbad, the offspring of the 12 sons of Yaqub, Jacob, Yaqub. Are you saying that they were Jewish or Christians? Because the Jewish and Christian, they claim they following Prophet Musa was a Jewish, Isa was this. Were they those who came even before Prophet Musa and Isa? Prophet Musa and Isa came way after Prophet Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq and Yaqub. and asbab. They came after them. Are you saying that they were a Jewish or a Christians? قُلْ أَأَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ Say, do you know better? Or does Allah? It's a very clear answer. يعني the way of the argument of Quran. Do you know better or Allah? The answer is very clear. Allah knows better. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَتَّمَ شَهَادَةً عِنْدَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ And who is more unjust than he who concealed the testimony he has from Allah. Who is more unjust? أَيْلَا أَحَدَ أَظْلَمُ No one is more unjust than the one who conceals a testimony he has from Allah. In knowledge, he has it. Knowledge from Allah, he has it. He concealing it. The knowledge they conceal these people is that Prophet Ibrahim and those messengers mentioned were not Christian, they were not Jewish. They came way before the Christianity and the Judaism. How can they be? Yani, what's the another ayah in Surah, in the same Surah, Surah Al-Imran? قُلْ أَتُحَاجُّونَنَا يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لِمَا تُحَاجُّونَ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمِ وما أنزلت التوراة والإنجيل إلا من بعد أفلا تعقلون توراة and إنجيل was only sent down after Prophet Ibrahim. How you attach yourself to him? Don't you have عقل? Don't you have understanding? Like someone who says to you, be Shi'i or be Sufi, for instance. How you call me to Sufi Shi'i? Prophet Sallam, his time there was no Sufi, there's no Shi'i. And you attaching this thing to Prophet Muhammad. It came after Prophet Muhammad. Don't you have understanding? Subhanallah. Naam. Tilka ummatun qad khalat laha ma kasab. That was a nation who has passed away. That was a nation, those prophets, who the Jewish and Christian attached themselves to them and they claim that they are on their path. They are people who proceeded. They are people who pass away. They shall receive the reward of what they earn. وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ And you, of what you earn. وَلَا تُسْأَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ And you will not be asked of what they used to do. So leave this claiming, false claiming, and being proud of something you have no right in it, leave it aside. And worship Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala alone and follow His message. That's what benefits you. Al-amalu salih, al-imanu sahih, wal-amalu salih. The sound belief and the righteous actions. Not just we follow in Ibrahim, we follow in Musa, we follow in Isa alayhi wasallam, which has no base. It's just a claiming. Tilka ummatun qad khalat laha ma kasabat, wa lakum ma kasabtum. ولا تسألون عما كانوا يعملون والله أعلم صلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد